everyone. I'm Jiffer.
I'm Mike.
I'm Winded.
I'm Lofty.
This is the Quadrofeelia. The goal here with this instrument was to come up with an alternative to pedal steel instrument, which I think is a really expressive instrument. There's a lot of control that you can use to change the sound, morph the sound. It's usually played with a volume pedal, and you can bend pitches with the pedals. And so that was kind of the inspiration. And what we have here is kind of similar layout in that there's kind of strings over here and a fretboard over here. Since it's on a computer, we've got the advantage of being able to retune the virtual strings on the fly just by the press of a button. So for instance, by default, we have it tuned to a minor seventh chord. The next button tunes it to fourths, which is like a bass guitar or guitar tuning. So you can do, if you're familiar with that kind of instrument, you can play it like that. But the next one does fifths and then seconds. So it gives you a lot of flexibility on the fly to just quickly change things. The other thing that we have is the four touch-sensitive, position-sensitive resistors over here have different zones, and so you can bend them up as well while you're playing it. So I think it gives a lot of expressivity. And then lastly, there's a force-sensitive resistor underneath this other strip, so we have kind of two modes on this one, which allows it to respond to the position and the amount of pressure. Oh, and there's one other resistor. We have a force-sensitive resistor here, which allows you to mute the string.
Control it with your palm.
So it doesn't resonate, doesn't ring as long. So I'll let these guys talk about some of the other specifics.
Cool. So much like the group that came before us, the slobber group, we really wanted it to be an instrument that somebody could walk up to and have no idea what it is, just look at it and then kind of feel it and be like, ooh, that's cool. So we wanted somebody who has no knowledge of it to be able to play it pretty well, but we also wanted to have the capability of someone to spend some time with it and actually develop technique and play it like an actual instrument. So the way that this works, it's very nice and very clean. That was the aesthetic on top. It's just one horizontal strip and then four vertical strips and then the buttons. And then this is all running through just several very easily drilled holes to the bottom. That's the most stressful thing I've ever done in my life, drilling through this, because you know if you mess up, it's like one shot. And this is really nice, expensive wood we've got here. So we're running it down. We've got our Beagle board is mounted on the side here, so it's easily accessible. So, you know, 5 years from now, when these things are all over the world and everyone is buying them and loves them, they'll be able to access it and make changes and fix it and everything. And then we've got it, we have our power output right here and our audio output. So they're just two easy holes on the side, so it's easy to wire it up. And we can also access, if we need to ever, you know, tap into it like we just did earlier, if it ever shuts down for no reason, we have no idea. We have our Ethernet jack right there, so you can just go into it whenever you'd like. So we just wanted to make it really clean and aesthetically pleasing so that anyone could walk up to it and have fun with it. That was our construction idea.
Is there anything else for me to talk about? I'm going to talk a little bit more about the technical aspects of it. I mean, we covered the interval spacing on these strings. One of the aspects that I worked really hard on was trying to make it so that you can have certain zones where no matter where you are within the zone, I'm moving my finger, but I don't get a different pitch. But then if I go a little higher, I can bend it up until I get into the next zone, and then there's a certain amount that I can move my finger, and then there's another zone that I can change it. So it's cool, you know, if I were to have all my fingers on that zone, then I can do it just by changing the button. it's really easy to just come up to and just play. I think for a demonstration, though, give it a shot.
Cool.
Something else that we added was this on the left-hand fretboard side. It's quite nice. We wanted a bit of variation for the sound, which like Jeffrey touched upon. And we wanted to map it kind of to a guitar. So similarly, when you press really hard on the fret, it pitches up slightly. So as well as like getting a lot sharper timbrely. In terms of sound design, I think what we did, so you got some sawtooth waves in there, and we doubled them up on the octave and like detuned a little bit, so it sounded almost like a 12 string. And then there's also that a sort of sharpened FM thing that envelope opens up on. So you can get more of those kind of sounds. And then, yeah, the buttons are just pretty much talked about them, so.
The nice thing is that it's easy to control with the right hand, with your thumb. It's nicely placed so that, you know, if you want to control it with your left hand, that's fine, but it's also controllable from your right hand, even if you have your hand on the resistors that needs the sound, you can still hit all the buttons with your thumb pretty easily.
One other thing I just wanted to just point out before Lucky plays a little bit on it is we preserve the ability, the thing that you have with the pedal steel of holding a position and being able to bend to a new chord, which is done on a pedal steel with the pedals by, you know, you step down one or two pedals, or let them up, and it bends two or one or more strings, which changes the chord. And so because you can bend these with your right hand, you can it kind of gives you the option of having different voicings, since straight across it's just one voicing, but there's a lot of different possibilities, especially with the different sort of tunings that you get with the buttons. And we really haven't explored or learned all the different possibilities and the different kind of chord shapes, but I think the point is, the nice thing is that without having to know too much, you can play basic things, but there's enough complexity in there that you could
learn different
really
techniques.
Get deep and like learn a lot of different ways to play various chords, which with combined with the left hand, you could, I think, play a lot of cadences and interesting progressions and that sort of thing, as well as being able to do single note passages. So.
Well, I guess I'm going to take it for a spin and try and improvise. It's quite challenging, actually, I'm not going to lie. It is kind of like learning a new instrument, so we'll just see if I can do it.
Thank you.
It's also really fun to play with other people.
Yeah, like, if you have multiple people playing, then yeah, you can play off what other people do. So it's not just a one-person instrument. You can have multiple people doing it.
What's your favorite feature?
I don't know.
I think, and this was something that we didn't have until the end, because we had the FSR stopped working. But I think the fact that mold the sound with pressure, it's a real natural thing to be able to do, I think, just by applying more pressure
over here. Does it feel squishier when you can hear the sound than it does when you don't hear the sound?
You mean when you play the actual keys over here? These ones really don't. These ones don't have any kind of feedback like that. Over here, you can definitely, you know, there's two resistors. There's a position sensor. There's also just a planar force sensitive resistor over here. So this one, when you're pressing down, you can feel a little squish. Just like over here on the mutes, you can feel a little bit. But over here, it doesn't take any force at all. You don't really have to press it to get. You can press hard if you want to, but pressing hard doesn't really do much on these guys.
So I mean, I think there's probably room for it adding another force-sensitive resistor over here, so right. Pressure controls volume or something, another parameter, and after laying it out, I also think there's no reason that you couldn't have more than four on here. The name would probably have to change, but it's pretty natural to just strum across it, and you could pack more of them in here, and if you know if they were sustaining more, it'd be more like a big 10-string pedal steel or something like that, which you could have a lot of different tunings again. And since you know you could just kind of pluck each one in different spots, but I think as it is, it really gives a lot of flexibility.
Other questions?
Thank you, Jeffrey. Okay. Thank you.